What's going on, everybody? Welcome to Sports Talk with Bros. This is weird. The Philadelphia Phillies lose, and I'm not upset. I'm going to be honest with you. Heading into this ball game, heading into this series, facing up against the New York Yankees, who are obviously a World Series-type squad, I didn't have that much high expectations. On top of that, we started Vince Velasquez today. So am I really sitting there saying, we're going to dominate? No. And early on in this game, Vince Velasquez was struggling, trying to find his way. Now, he didn't end up doing absolutely awful statistically, but he was a little bit out there for the first few innings, trying to find his way. Maybe the energy of the crowd. I mean, Citizens Bank Park was absolutely packed. Now, there were a lot of Yankees fans, and as a Phillies fan, I'm a little bit upset, but I'm going to be honest with you. I feel like half those fans are from Philadelphia, but they're Yankees fans, and you know, not just the way the Yankees fans are. Oh, yeah, I'm a huge Yankees fan. Okay, you're from Philly, bruh. You're from Philly. But you know, that kind of hurt me, but at the same time, it was cool to see Citizens Bank Park all lit up, all packed, and it was really awesome to see. So Vince Velasquez's stat line is he does go six innings. He allows 3 hits, 2 earned runs, 7 strikeouts, and 4 walks. Like I said, he was a little bit all over the place. Hector Neris finds his way in 1 inning with 2 strikeouts. He gets called up due to injury to this bullpen. We did go through a decent amount of pitchers there, but let's dissect this one. There wasn't much to it, honestly. Halfway through this game, it was a little bit boring. It wasn't that entertaining. The Phillies only had 3 hits, and in the top of the second is when they only scored 1 run, the Yankees did. They had opportunities to score a little bit more, but Vince Velasquez finds himself getting out of an inning. That could have been a lot worse. Then in the top of the first, or fifth, Aaron Judge hits a line drive homer that just goes over the wall, and that is a solo shot, 2-0. Bottom of the seventh, though, after Santana gets aboard, you have Scott Kingery, who singles to left, and that scores Carlos Santana. We cut the lead in half. I'm thinking, maybe, is there a possibility we find a way to do this? But in the eighth inning, Stanton singles to center. That scores 2 runs, 4-1. And the bottom of the ninth, Michael Franco crushed one. He gets on the board, a solo shot, 4-2, but there wasn't much there. We struggled offensively big time today. We struggled to see the New York Yankees rookie sensation on the mound today. Cesar Hernandez, 0-for-4. Reese Hoskins, 0-for-4. Odubel Herrera, 0-for-3. Carlos Santana, 0-for-2. Did walk twice, though. I mean, that can't happen, right? Nick Williams, 0-for-4. You had Franco, Kingery, and Alfaro with the 3 hits today. I didn't have that much high expectations coming in. I really didn't. When you look at the stat lines for the Yankees, you have Aaron Judge getting himself 2 hits and Stanton going 2-for-3 and walking as well with 2 RBIs. But, I mean, we are facing a legitimate threat in this league. We are facing a team that is one of the best, if not the best, in baseball. So this series, I'm kind of relaxed. I'm just sitting back and saying, let's see what the Phillies team can do. It was 4-2. Yes, we struggled offensively a little bit, but it wasn't like an absolute dominant performance, and we didn't even have that great of pitching. So for them to only score 4 runs, for Vince to not have a good night, really, and only let up 2 runs. I mean, it could have been a lot worse with the circumstances that were there. So, yes, we fall. I get it. I want to take one of this series. That's my game plan. I got to be realistic with myself, right? We have the worst bullpen in the MLB. We're not going to be able to rely on our bullpen to be able to beat teams like the Yankees, who are legit World Series contenders this year. We're not there yet. But I would like to see this team fight and show me some effort. I'll be honest with you. Scott Kingery with that RBI, I love him. I really do. It's his work ethic. It's his approach to the game, his defense, his hustle, his energy. I love Scott Kingery. He brings something to this team and to the table that really catches my eye. And I mean, I'm at the point where I'm thinking, damn, do I get a Scott Kingery jersey? No lie. I mean, we signed him for a long time. I love the way he plays the game. I really do. And he's going to be here for a lot of time, hopefully. Hopefully. He doesn't get dealt in a Manny Machado trade. But I can't see that happening. So here we go. The Yankees come to Citizens Bank Park and they take game one. Let's see how this Phillies team bounces back. I would love to just take a game in this series. I hate to like think that way, but I'm just trying to be realistic, right? That's what I'm trying to do. It's clear as day this Phillies team isn't as good as the New York Yankees, and we don't have a successful bullpen. So, you know, one game, one game, one game. That's all I ask for out of this series. Let's see if we can do it. Make sure you hit that thumbs up button, subscribe, comment down below. Thank you so much for watching. I'll see you next time.